Welcome, dear students. Welcome to lecture 3 of module 4, that is flux meter. What is a flux meter? This is the actual form of a flux meter. It is a meter used for measuring the flux phi of permanent magnet type, such type of instrument. That is, for example, moving iron instrument, in moving coil instrument, we are using permanent magnet. So for such type of instrument, in order to measure the flux, we are using flux meter. It is an advanced form of ballistic galvanometer, which has certain advantage, like meter has low controlling torque and heavy electromagnetic damping. Low controlling and heavy electromagnetic damping provide accurate reading. The construction of flux meter, it is shown in figure. This is the flux meter. It has a coil. This is the coil. It is freely suspended by the help of spring. This is spring. It is freely suspended by the help of spring. Okay. And a single silk thread. This is single silk thread. Spring, single silk thread, which is at the end, there will be a coil. Coil moves freely between the poles of magnet. There is a two permanent magnet. In between, we are suspending the coil and it is free to move. The terminals of flux meter. These two are the terminals of flux meter. These two are connected as shown in figure. Connected across the surge coil. So we are using a surge coil, that is an inductive coil here, whose flux is to be measured. Either coil the flux and measuring, you have to use that coil here. So you have to place a surge coil in between these two coil or terminal. And this is the electrical representation. EF represent the EMF of flux meter or total flux meter. This is your EF. Okay, EMF produced from total flux meter, and EC is the EMF induced in the surge coil. Okay. The flux linking with the coil is varied by either removing it from magnetic field or reversing the field of magnet. So you are connecting a coil here. Search coil or coil to be tested here. Search coil means coil whose flux to be measured. And how will you produce change in flux linkage? There are two methods, either by reversing the field of magnet, continuously reversing north and south pole, or by removing and inserting your search coil. In this way, you can change the flux linkage. The change of flux induces EMF in the coil. Due to change in flux linkage, there is an EMF induced in the surge coil. EMF induces the current in surge coil. As a result, a current will be flowing from surge coil through the flux meter. Because of current, pointer here in the coil, this is the coil. Here we are connecting the pointer. Because of this current, the pointer of the flux meter will deflect, and that deflection is proportional to rate of change of flux linkage. So this is the working principle. So what actually we are doing, we are connecting a surge coil here in the terminal, and in order to produce the rate of change or change in flux, either you have to reverse the north and south pole immediately, or by removing and inserting this surge coil. In this way, you can change the flux. Once there will be change in flux, there will be an EMF in the surge coil. That EMF produces a current, and current will be flowing through this flux meter, and due to that current, the pointer connected to this coil start moving and it get deflect. The magnetic flux is directly proportional to deflection obtained. Okay. So the deflection of coil is proportional to the which parameter? Flux. Flux is due to that current. Let R and L is the total inductance and reluctance of the circuit of the comprising of meter coil and surge coil. Then N is the number of turns on the surge coil. So this is number of turn, and R and L or RFLF. So you'll be having resistance. R means RF is the resistance and inductance of surge coil. RF and LF, sorry. There is a correction here. In R and L represent total resistance and inductance of this flux meter and surge coil. This is correct. Okay. This is with this figure. This we need. This actually RFLF is the resistance of flux meter coil, and RCLC is the resistance and inductance of search coil, and sum of RF and R is R. LF and LC is L. Okay. So in total, here it is written as R and L are the total resistance and inductance. N is the number of turns. Phi is the flux linkage, and I is the current flowing through the circuit. So the EMF induced in a search coil, here is the search coil. EMF induced in search coil is EC. At any instant is given as EC equal to E. Both are same. E equal to number of turns into rate of change of flux linkage, N into d phi by dt. So EC or E equal to N into d phi by dt. Next, EMF induced in the flux meter. In the flux meter, we are connecting the pointer, and the deflection is produced in the flux meter. So you can write EB, that is flux meter EMF equal to K into d theta by dt. There is a change in notation here. So please cope with that. E means EC. E is search coil EMF, and EB is flux meter or EF. Here it is EF is K into d theta by dt. So here is the correct notation, E equal to EC and EB equal to EF. If K is, where K is the constant of flux meter, which depend upon the dimension of instrument. EMF due to inductance of the circuit, total inductance L equal to LF plus LC. So L into DI by DT is the EMF due to inductance in the circuit, and voltage drop in the resistance is given by I into R. Okay, so the equation connecting electrical quantities can be written as EC equal to EF plus L into DI by DT plus I into R. So this is the equation for EMF induced in the search coil. That is EF plus L into DI by DT plus R into I. Since the resistance of circuit as well as current flowing through the circuit are small, so we can neglect the term RI. Okay. So resistance offered by the circuit is very small. As a result, due to flux linkage, the current value is also small. So we can write RI can be neglected. So EC become EF plus L into DI by DT. We know EC equal to N into d phi by DT, and EF equal to K into d theta by DT. Substitute these values, you will be getting N into d phi by DT equal to K into d theta by DT plus L into DI by DT. Next, integrate over each parameters. Since there will be rate of change of flux from 0 to t, integrate over 0 to t, where t is the time taken for flux change, N into d phi by dt into dt equal to integral 0 to t k into d theta by dt plus L into di by dt into t. Integrate all the terms with respect to dt. So dt dt can be cancelled, you will be getting, so the limit also changed. Limit changed from integral phi 1 to phi 2. Let phi 1 and phi 2 be the flux linking with the search coil, and theta 1 and theta 2 be the deflection corresponding to the change in flux. When flux is phi 1, let theta 1 be the deflection produced by search flux meter, and I 1 be the current through search coil. And when flux linked to phi 2, let theta 2 be the deflection and I 2 be the current. So you can substitute corresponding limit here. Integral phi 1 to phi 2 and d phi equal to integral theta 1 to theta 2 k into dt theta plus integral I 1 to I 2 L into di. Since inductor opposes the rate of change of current, we can write I 1 to I 2 L into di. Rate of change of current equal to 0. You can apply integral I1 to I2 L into DI equal to 0. So you can write integrating this term N into applying the limit phi 2 to phi 1. So N into phi 2 minus phi 1 equal to K into theta 2 minus theta 1. This is theta 1, it's a mistake. So or theta 2 minus theta 1 equal to N by K into this equation. So from this, what is D phi? D phi is K by N into theta 2 minus theta 1. So this is the equation for change in flux linkage obtained from the flux meter. Okay, thank you.